Have you ever had this experience? You get a full night's sleep, you get 8 hours, maybe more of sleep, but when you wake up in the morning, you're tired, you're groggy, you have to chug 5 cups of coffee just to get through the day, and you're just staring at the clock all day at work, just waiting for when you can get home and take a nap. Have you ever had that experience? I know I have. Most people will tell you the reason you don't have energy is because you have to sleep more, or you have to exercise more, or you have to cover up that little red light on your alarm clock that's ruining your circadian rhythm. And while there's probably some truth to those things, they're missing the big 400-pound gorilla, which in my experience determines 90% of your energy levels. In this video, I'm going to tell you the real reason your energy is so low and how to fix it. If you've ever worked in any corporate environment, you know that cubicle drones run on coffee. They can't get through a single day without coffee. And in their off time, they share little memes on Facebook joking about how they can't function without coffee. Like, teehee, I don't have the energy to stay awake for a full day without some external stimulant to use as a crutch. Isn't that cute? It's kind of become the new normal. Everybody's tired all the time and nobody has any energy. The coffee and Red Bull and 5-hour energy might keep them awake at their desks, but only just barely. And then the people who are more proactive and health conscious will try to figure out exactly what diet and what exercise plan and what exact number of hours of sleep will give them more energy. When I was still a cubicle drone, I went through all of this and I took it even further. I bought blackout shades and covered up all the little lights on the electronic devices in my room so it would be perfectly dark at night. I would stop using electronics an hour before bed so that I could adjust into sleep mode. I set my thermostat on a timer so that it would get cold at night and then warm in the morning to mimic the Earth's natural heat cycles. I even bought an alarm clock that used light rather than sound to wake me up. It would get gradually brighter over time, so it was like the sun rising. It seemed like I was doing everything perfect, and it helped a little bit, but I still didn't really have energy throughout the day. It took me a long time to figure out what was the real problem, and I found it kind of by accident. I'll tell you that story in a second, but first, I already asked you if you've had the experience of getting a good night's sleep, but then having no energy the next day. Well, have you also had the opposite experience? Have you ever gotten 4 hours of sleep one night, and then the next day been totally wired and excited and full of energy? Maybe you were doing everything wrong, according to the traditional advice. Maybe your diet sucked and you weren't exercising and you were drinking a lot of beer and you weren't getting enough sleep, but you still had energy. What's going on here? By the way, if you're enjoying this video, please do me a huge favor, hit the thumbs up button, and leave me a comment because this tells YouTube that you like the video so they start showing it more. And if this is valuable to you and you want more videos like this, be sure to also hit the subscribe button and hit the little bell icon beside the subscribe button. Okay, now let me tell you when I started having energy consistently. I started having energy when I quit my job and started working for myself. Sure, I sleep a little later and I still drink coffee sometimes, but it isn't like when I was working the corporate job where I had to drink coffee just to get by. Now I drink coffee every once in a while if I want to have a super productive day. It's pretty awesome, and I like coffee anyway, so that's a perk. But the point is, I finally figured out what was the major factor in my baseline energy levels. It wasn't sleep or diet or exercise or mimicking a more primitive lifestyle. It wasn't anything physical, actually. The answer was spiritual. I was tired because I was doing the wrong things. I'll explain more what I mean by that, but first, think about why you feel the things that you feel. There's a good reason for every negative feeling. If you feel hungry, it's a sign that you need to eat. If you feel afraid, it's a sign that you need to remove yourself from some impending danger. If you feel disgust, it's a warning to stay away from something that could cause disease. So what if you feel tired? Well, I believe that that means that whatever you're doing, you need to stop doing. If you're up at 3 a.m. playing video games and you start to feel tired, that's an indication that you need to stop playing video games and get some sleep. If you're constantly tired, sitting in your dusty cubicle, pushing papers every day, that's a sign that you need to quit being a drifter and start actually proactively doing something meaningful with your life. This is your soul telling you that what you are doing is not what you were put on this earth to do. Body and soul work together. They're not separate, they're two parts of the same machine. If your spirit feels that something is wrong and you ignore your spirit, it will create physical signs in your body to try to get your attention. And the more you ignore those physical signs, the worse they will get. By the way, I'm not telling you that you should always do exactly what your feelings tell you to do. You're not an animal, you're not a slave to your instincts. If you start to feel hungry in the middle of an important meeting, you don't just walk out in the middle and get lunch. I'm just saying that negative feelings indicate a problem, and you should probably do something about that problem before it makes your life completely miserable. Now, have you noticed that when you have a lack of energy, you also feel unfulfilled? That's a spiritual feeling and a physical feeling that come as a pair. When your spirit is unfulfilled, your body is tired. It's a spiritual problem that's causing a physical feeling. So if you try to treat the physical feeling using physical means like diet, exercise, sleep, etc., it's just not going to work very well because you're ignoring the root problem. And I'm not saying that these are bad things. Taking care of your body is important. I'm just saying that physical interventions aren't going to solve a spiritual problem. Now, think again about a time when you didn't get much sleep but had a lot of energy. What was going on in your mind? Probably you were excited about something. Maybe there was a big opportunity, or you met somebody that you really liked, or you knew that something very good was about to happen to you, or you just had an amazing flash of inspiration, right? For that moment, your spirit was happy and it gave you a big rush of energy that completely overwhelmed your physical exhaustion. If you live by the Empire of Nothing's rules, then probably you don't experience this very often. But what if I told you that this can be and should be your normal daily experience? Just like being tired all the time is your soul telling you that you're doing the wrong things, having inexhaustible positive energy every day of the week is your soul telling you that you are doing the right things. So, if you want to have energy, do the right things. Do the things that fulfill the mission that you chose for yourself before you were conceived. If you don't know what those things are, listen to your spirit and listen to your body. You have those indicators to guide you. If what you're doing is leaving you tired and unfulfilled, try doing something else. And if that something else leaves you tired and unfulfilled, try something else again. Try until you find the thing that gives you inexhaustible spiritual energy, that makes you excited to get out of bed in the morning. That's how you know that you've found it. I'll be talking a lot more in future videos about how to find your mission. I talk about this because it excites me and it gives me energy to help other people find their mission. So I believe that this is part of my mission. So if that's something that interests you, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and hit the little bell icon beside the subscribe button so that you don't miss anything that could transform your life. If you think this information could make somebody else's life better, take a moment to share this video. If you've ever seen the movie Fight Club, which is one of my favorites, and you can identify with the feelings of emptiness in our modern empire of nothing, then check out this video to see what it says about you.